Coming up on the Football and Freedom Show, we discuss a couple of the biggest scandals going on in the country today. Joe Biden, is he a foreign agent? And of course, the medical situation, players dropping dead. Is it connected? You probably know the answer to that. In the cunt bag of the week, we have to discuss the 60-year-old Finland ice skater man who thinks he's a woman and whether or not that's his fault or the people encouraging him. And in the angel of the week, Project Veritas, all the fantastic work they're doing over there to expose Big Pharma. All that and much more coming to you right now.
Nobody's stronger than me.
Nobody has better toys than I do.
There's nobody bigger or better at the military than I am.
Nobody loves the Bible more than I do.
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by you know the thing.
Man, you are one pathetic loser.
Back in 82, I used to be able to throw a pigskin a quarter mile.
Are you serious?
I'm dead serious.
All right now, baby, all right. 60 minutes falls out. Let's open up the whole can of kick ass and kill them all. Let the paramedics sort them out.
The world is going to end in 12 years if we don't address climate change.
Here we go again. Can you imagine what they must think of it? These people are crazy.
I'm your huckleberry.
You want answers?
I think I'm entitled.
You want answers?
I want the truth.
Shit, Negro. That's all you had to say.
Yoo-hoo. I'll make you famous.
Guitar riff. This is the Football and Freedom Show. I am your host, James Mock, and today we're going to do a little bit different. It's been a little bit since I've done a video, so I want to reintroduce kind of myself, what I do here on the Football and Freedom Show, and what we do overall at the Revolution Network and all the shows that we offer with that. So number one, I guess I'll start with the Revolution Network. Our goal is to provide you, the audience, the truth as close as we can get to it while making it funny and loose and inviting. One of our shows, The Bastards of Babylon, that you get if you subscribe, it's me and my business partner, Bo Cephas. We get on there, we chop it up, we talk about what's going on. It's not necessarily supposed to be just him and I. The intent of that show was to bring on guests, make it inviting, bring on people who disagree with us, because we believe that, you know, the only way to find as close as you can get to the truth is to have freedom of thought, freedom of speech. And when you do that, you are at risk of, people's feelings getting hurt. And that's okay. You know, if you come on here, you disagree with us and you want to hurt our feelings, you think you hurt our feelings, that's fine. We might hurt your feelings with some of the things that we say, but that's how you get to an overall consensus and as close as you can to the truth. In my experience, certain people just don't want to have any dialogue with you. They want to just call you all the isms and the is, the racist, homophobic, transphobic, you just racist, sexist, all bigot, all that bullshit. That gets you nowhere. So at the Bachelors of Babylon, we invite people to come on. Let's come together, get as close as we can to agreement. We're not going to agree on everything, but that's the beauty of this country. We can have disagreement. We can all live together under one umbrella of ideas and move along with our day, which takes me to the other section of this. And that is what I do here on the Football and Freedom Show. It's an individual show. It's just my own individual thoughts on what I think is going on in the world. sprinkled in with some football, because there's nothing I love better in the world than football and freedom. And actually, it's all the F's. I mean, I should really change the name of this show to all the F's you care about. Football, freedom, faith, family, friends, food, fucking. It's just all the good stuff start with F. I don't know why it's that way. Maybe that's divine intervention with language. I don't know. But that's what I do here. Try to make it loose. Try to make it funny. Won't necessarily bring guests onto this show, but not against it. If we can somehow get a guest, which is very hard to do because nobody who disagrees with us likes to come on. But if I can, I will invite them to the Bastards of Babylon show. Also, the I Mean It show. That is the individual show with my partner, Bocephus. He does deep dives into analytics, numbers, you know, just very, very over my head stuff. So if you're into that, whether it's football, betting, sports betting in general, it could even be off topic of sports. If it requires a deep dive and it lights a fire under his ass, he's going to get into it over there. So you can find that. And then of course the flagship football glory hole. It is started as a podcast. It still is only in audio form, but if you subscribe to the Revolution Network, you will get that show in your feed. And that is a weekly podcast production, breaking down all the games in the NFL, giving out free picks, sounders, big dick picks, teasers, all the good shit you get during the football season, you can find right there at the Football Glory Hole podcast. So that's a rundown of what we do here. But again, this is my show, and the way I do it is a little bit different, but I mean, different is fun. That's why you have a variety of things you can choose from. Oh, so what's going on in our world today? In my opinion, we're living through the biggest presidential scandal in the history of our country. And that's saying something, because we have had some absolute douchebag presidents on both sides of the aisle. I hope that when you watch this show, you will notice and recognize that I am not a Republican shill. I am not here to, you know, pump sunshine up the ass of Republicans and just put down Democrats. I believe that they're all pretty much evil. And the way our Constitution was written and the way it's supposed to be done is limited government. Don't tread on me. Stay away. Stay out of our business. Like government has grown to a level that it was never intended to be. Government is supposed to be to, you know, protect us, military, police, fire, stuff like that, and everything. And that's the federal level, and everything else pushed down to the subsidiary level, city, state, and then federal. We've reversed it. It's completely backwards. Now everything, you know, that happens locally, we go to, or, you know, people cry to the federal level to fix it. And that's just not the way it was supposed to be. So, you know, the Constitution, I think it's the best document ever written, the best, formula for how to run a country that there ever has been. And that's why people are dying to get here. They're standing in lines by the millions to illegally come into this country. So, you know, when you hear people bitching about this country, just kindly remind them that, hey, you know, yes, there's some things that we're not perfect, and there's some things that we could do better, but there is a line wrapped around the block waiting to get in. So we must be doing something right. Life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. That's fundamentally core to this country. And the Constitution, the way it's written, it is, these rights are given to us by God to be protected by the government, not given to us by government. Like if these rights were given to us by government, they can be taken away by government, but that's not how it's written. These rights are given to us by God to be protected by the government. And if they fail to do so, we have the right to remove them, whether that's through democracy, voting them out, or you fuck around and find out, and then maybe at some point it's time to physically remove these people. And I'm not one of those people that says, oh, you can't talk about You can't talk about insurrection and going against your government. The fuck I can't. That's how this country was built. That's how this country was made. Okay, if government's not doing what they're supposed to do, if they're not upholding their end of the bargain, and we can't change them through democracy, then we will change them through force. So I guess I'm one of those rare people that like calls for more uprisings, more organized uprisings. And if it gets to a point, not that bullshit fake thing that happened January 6th, like that was not an insurrection. You don't have an insurrection with no weapons. You can't overthrow a government with no weapons. And the fact that they, within hours, cleared everybody out and conducted business as usual proves that that was not an insurrection. That was just trespassing with a bunch of morons doing a bunch of stupid shit. No, no, no. What I would call for, and what I will call for if it gets to the point, is a real insurrection with armed people. Go to war with the government. Again, that's pie in the sky. We don't need to get to that point. Let's just hold these people accountable to do the right thing and do what they're supposed to do for us. I'm going to try to keep it funny and loose on this show. I'll normally have a monologue going into more detail onto a current situation, but this kind of took most of my time at the opening, going over kind of what we do here at the Revolution Network. So please, if you haven't done it already, please subscribe, share, spread it around, because you can get this news anywhere. You can get your current events anywhere. You can get your daily, monthly, weekly breakdowns anywhere, but you can't get it the way we're going to do it here. So I hope we offer something different, something new, something special to you, and you like it, and you subscribe, and you spread it around. So with that out of the way, let's get to the cunt bag of the week.
He was a cunt.
Smash the granny out of cunt.
Little cunt.
Little cunt.
Scruffy cunt.
You're a cunt.
Cunt. Cunt.
Cunt!
You will never hear me use that word.
Absolute cunt.
I'm so proud of you.
All right, well, I tease it in the beginning, and the cunt bag of the week actually is not going to be the 60-year-old man ice skater dressed up like a female in a leotard who, in Finland, if you haven't seen it, you know what? Just show the video right now.
Alkaa luistella naismoodissa, vaikka syntyperäisin oinkin mies. Ja sieltä on niin kuin 9 vuotta aikaa, eli siihen 9 vuoteen sisältyy aika paljon. Eli kun lähdetään ihan nollasta, niin ihan jo sitä, että pysyy pystyssä 2 jalalla, pysyy pystyssä 1 jalalla, ja sen jälkeen rupeaa niin kuin uskaltamaan tehdä jotakin siellä jäällä. Ja sitten alkaa pikkuhiljaa kisaamaan ja esiintymään näytöksissä ja niin edelleen. Että sanotaan, että aika kivaa uraa on ollut, mutta tietysti korona tuli vähän sitten väliin, että se sitten sotki kuviota. Mutta eteenpäin mennään ja homma jatkuu.
Men slogan on, tule sellaisena kuin ole.
Courageous. So courageous. God damn it, don't you people get it? I'm trying to get fired here.
All right. I mean, look, it's hard not to laugh at that because it is fucking hilarious to see a grown-ass man in a leotard fall down on the ice and not be able to get, he can't even get up. You know why? Because he's fucking old and he shouldn't be out there. But here's the point. He's not the cunt bag of the week. No, 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 no. It's not him. Look, I feel bad for him. I do. He has a mental disorder. He thinks he's a woman at 60 and he needs help. This man needs help, but the help he needs is not being paraded out in front of the fucking world for him to go out there on the ice and fall down on his fat ass and not be able to get up. That's not helping him. That is not helping him. And to all the people online that I've gotten into who are calling me the worst person in the world because I notice a grown man in a leotard fall down on the ice, fuck you. Go to hell. This is your fault. So they are the cunt bags of the week. The people supporting this, encouraging this, pushing him to, yes, you chase your dreams and you go get that trophy. No, that's your fault that he did this. It's your fault that everybody's laughing at him. I wish that he wasn't out there. And to the people that are saying, well, just let him be what he wants to be. Go to the local ice rink if you want to go be an ice skater. Throw on your fucking leotard, go out to the local ice rink and fall down all you want. Nobody's going to care. Matter of fact, most people will come and help you up. because we're good people. But when you parade that shit out on a national stage and you force that agenda on all of us, don't get mad at us. Don't get mad at me when I notice and I say, keep your fuckery in your neighborhood and don't push it on me. Don't tread on me. That's what I got to say about that. But look, it's your fault if you encourage it. Men can't be women. Not everybody gets a trophy. And do your weird shit in your own space. That's all I'm going to say. So, in a world full of cunt bags, sometimes we need an angel. Send me an angel. All right, and the angel of the week is Project Veritas. If you're not familiar with Project Veritas and all the badass investigative journalism they do over there, you need to follow them because fuck all those bullshit network news stations. They don't bring you the real deal. This is true journalism, and they expose a Pfizer executive, my God, explaining what they're doing with gain of function right here in the United States. And risking us to another pandemic. Matter of fact, just, you know what? Play the tape.
Hey there. Is this seat taken?
You work for Pfizer. My question for you is, why does Pfizer want to hide from the public the fact that they're mutating the COVID viruses?
Is this real life? I'm literally a liar. I was trying to impress a person on a date by lying.
And please,
this is
please,
absurd.
Please don't touch me.
Well, this is not, by the way,
why
don't,
are you doing
don't
this?
Tell
this
anybody.
This is someone who is just working at a company to literally help the public. You f***ed up. You really did. Please bring the cops as soon as possible. I feel very unsafe.
Can you please unlock your door?
No, you, no, don't let them leave.
Please unlock the door.
Give me, why is going on
give us
here?
Stuff. Please unlock. Please unlock the door. Please unlock the door. Unlock the door. We're trying to get unlock the door. Unlock the door.
I mean, look, Dr. Fauci went up there and lied about gain of function.
Senator Poole, that is not true. I do not do gain of function. I don't know where the virus, I don't know how it got into the Wuhan lab. I don't know how it escaped. Probably a fucking bat. Those fucking dirty bats flying around, exposing it. No,
they're doing the same fucking thing here right now. You just heard it. And in his defense, did you hear him? I'm just a liar. You don't believe me. I'm just a liar. Oh, that's your defense? I'm a liar? Well, then I think you're lying now that you're a liar. So I don't believe you. So again, check out Project Veritas. We have evil, evil shit going on right here under our nose all the time, whether it's Joe Biden and the corruption, him being a foreign agent and the corruption overseas with Ukraine and China and his son and all that dirty shit they're doing, Big Pharma, Pfizer doing all the dirty shit they're doing now and what they did over in the Wuhan lab. All this is happening right under your fucking noses. So wake up, pay attention. And if you disagree with anything I've said today, come on to the show, come on to Bastards of Babylon, and we'll hash it out. We'll through thought and speech and the freedom of those things, we will come as close as we can to the truth. So that's it for that. Let's get to the football part of the show and let's hand out some money.
There you go. There you go.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
Thank you, sir.
There you go.
All right. Well, obviously, we are going into the last game of the year. It is Super Bowl time. In the offseason with this show, it's going to get a little harder to do free picks with nothing going on. But we do have one game left, and the free pick is going to be, look, maybe I'm biased. I do have a 50-1 ticket on Philadelphia to win the Super Bowl. So I probably am leaning that way a little bit too much because of that. But I actually do think overall that Philadelphia just has the better roster top to bottom. Now with the quarterback situation, obviously Mahomes, he's that dude's Michael Jordan. How do you go against him? He's fucking Michael Jordan. Doesn't even matter if he gets fucking hurt. He's a baller. It's hard to go against him, and I get that. But Hurts is a badass this year. He's playing. Their levels of play are very close, and Philly has the better top-down roster. So I'm going to take free pick Philadelphia. You can get them at -1, -1.5. I would probably just put them on the money line, so you don't have to mess with all that. Got to pay a little extra vig, but that's all right. You can do that. It's not that much. So Philadelphia on the money line is the free pick of the week. And that is going to wrap it up for this episode of the Football and Freedom Show. Again, subscribe to the Revolution Network so you can get this show and all of the rest of them in the feed. And until next time, stay hard, stay hungry, join the revolution. And if you come in, come out.
Regulators. You regulate any stealing of his property, we're damn good too. But you can't be any geek off the street. Gotta be handy with the steel, if you know what I mean, earn your keep.
Regulators! Mount up!